I'm working for Munich Re. Munich Re is a primary and a reinsurer, the world's biggest reinsurer. And what we are dealing with is risks. And that means we have first a lot of data we're working with when we make our calculations. And we do a lot of risk assessment. And when we talk about resilience, resilient cities, data and knowledge about risk is essential for cities to manage their risks. And so we were very happy that we are sponsored this year for the first insurance summit here at the ECLAI event. And I think it's great that we start a cooperation between the financial sector and cities. Munich Re is very special because we realized many years ago, already in the 70s, that we see much more disasters happening due to natural hazards. And then we started to do a lot of on climate research, because we realized that this might result from the climate change. And since that time, we are collecting data, we are doing analysis, and we are also very much involved into political and regulatory discussions and bring in our knowledge, provide the data that we have collected. And we have a very broad knowledge, deep knowledge about natural hazards and the results of climate change and how especially climate change affects cities, because we realized quite early that cities are very vulnerable, that they are growing fast, that they are very often exposed to natural hazards because they are in regions, coastal regions, etc. And this is where we really can add value. And last year we have already been here and started a cooperation with other players from the insurance side, and broker, another Santam, the South African insurer, and Global Infrastructure Basel, and with the help of ECLAI, we set for the first time up a project called CIP, City Innovation Platform. And we wanted to talk directly to a city, not in a country where we have a high insurance penetration and a high standard and knowledge about risk management and available data. No, we wanted to talk to cities who stand at the beginning, so on the African continent. And the city we started with was Dar es Salaam, and ECLAI helped us to get in contact because they have a very good and close relationship to the mayor and the city officials of Dar. And so we had the chance last October to meet the city officials, to talk to the mayor, together with a group of insurers or people from the finance side, and we learned from each other. It was not that we educate them, they told us what really their problems are, what their needs are, and we explained them what would we need, what would we expect before we can give insurance, for example. So they have to protect their assets, they have to have a proper risk management. When they build or construct something, they have to adhere to certain regulations, standards. Then it is bankable and also insurable. And I think we have to proceed with that. That was a start. Now there will be a report about this CIP, so that every city can start to have an own city innovation platform to talk to the finance side and to learn from each other. And
when will this report be?
We hope that it will be finalized until today. We didn't manage to have it, but the next days, and I have a flyer. You can go to the website of ClimateWise. You will find a link to the report. You can download it then, and ECLAI played an important role for us. And ECLAI is now also a PSI signatory. The PSI is an initiative of the United Nations Environmental Programme Finance Initiative, the Principles for Sustainable Insurance. That means a group of insurers came together and said, yes, we want to we want to be a sustainable insurer. That means when we do our business, when we talk to clients, we want to take into account environmental, social and governance issues. And we as insurers can work together on that level under the roof of the PSI, under the roof of the UNEP, and also institutions can be a signatory, and ECLAI became a signatory right now. So we have a platform where we can work together and have much more exciting projects together with ECLAI. We want to work in a good environment, in stable economies, and this is what we can help to build them up. And it's a whole circle of resilience. It's first to be prepared, to know what could happen, to protect your assets, then to prevent the risks, and at the end also to know how to rebuild and to start after a disaster quickly with in the normal process. And we have seen, we have done a lot of research where we see that communities and economies that have an insurance protection or higher insurance penetration have a much faster recovery in a phase after a disaster. Today already in the discussions, the colleague from ICLEI Africa told us that they have already new projects with Dar and other cities, and when they listen to the concrete products we can offer, there have been other colleagues from the insurance side who are really from the business side, and I think we will have meetings and cooperations and try to find out whether certain products we have already constructed or have ideas for such products, whether they fit to the current projects cities are planning or doing, and I think we will keep in touch and go more on the business level. First it was a first meeting and a learn from each other, but maybe we can really talk in the next steps about specific products that could be of help. There are a lot of primary insurers, also reinsurers, that have the same mindset, and then you can work together across regions and continents. You share the same principles, and we now have the sustainable development goals. Everybody's aware that we have huge problems to solve, the climate change, all insurers and the whole finance industry is affected. So you can't almost find someone who's not aware of huge problems we have to solve, and this is the only possibility to do that is to work together, governments, finance industry, multilaterals, development banks, and so on. And so insurance alone can't solve all the problems, but we are a very important part of that. I think the cities have problems to be able to have a long-term planning because of the political issues. They have problems with the financing. And the insurance industry comes in usually at a very late stage when there's really a product, a project, a building, infrastructure project that are already planned, properly planned, and then we give insurance. We realize that we have to come together much earlier so that we can tell them if you would like to construct, to have a project, it has to look like that, otherwise you shouldn't even start. So we have to start much earlier to work together. In the developed world, maybe this is much more established. Of course, we have clients that are cities and have certain products, and it's in many regions or countries, it's regulated how it works with cities, governments, insurance, and so on. But I think the needs are different in countries who do not have a lot of insurance and a low penetration. And there we need maybe different schemes. And for example, we do a lot of private-public partnerships. This is where governments set up schemes. We help them. We take part of the risk. So the risk has to be shared on different shoulders.